is a wild place, and today we're going to be taking a look at just a handful, three options, or my top choices for taming it. So without any further ado, let's get into it. Before we jump into this, the first kind of point is to clarify intent. So when bushcrafting, because bushcrafting is so all-encompassing and very almost a generic term, it's really hard to just pick one rifle or one handgun to say this is the top bushcrafting firearm. You really have to define what you're after. So in this video, we're going to be breaking it down as my top self-protection option, my top hunting option, and a variable between the two. So to jump into this, making this quick and fast, the first one, or my top choice for self-protection, is going to be the Glock 20/21. Now this one is a 21 that you're seeing here, but really it's a toss-up between the two because they're both very similar in performance, size, capacity, basically everything. They're very similar. So this is my top choice because it's a lightweight and very portable option. And when you're thinking about self-defense, you're just going out there just kind of hiking or bushcrafting, and you just want something that's strictly to defend yourself. So the pros to the Glock for me, as I said, it's lightweight, has a good capacity, a good stopping power, but at the same time, it also is very easy to field strip and clean, which is important if you're working around dirty, dusty, sandy environments. Like when I was out by the river, there's a lot of silt in that area, so it's nice to just pop the slide off, clean the gun out how you need it to be cleaned out. So that's what I like about the Glock. Downside is to this option is it is very one-track minded, so it's not very good at anything else, just protection. However, it does that job very well, and that's why it makes my top choice for self-protection. It's a little bit bigger, and it may or may not fit fully on the screen, but it is a shotgun, and particularly this is a Mossberg 520 gauge. Now, the reason why I like 20 gauge is, one, the weight of the ammo is lower or less than a 12 gauge. Same with the overall weight of the firearm, it's less. So I like the 20 gauge for that reason. I also like the 20 gauge because it's still extremely versatile like a 12 gauge, and you can do pretty much all your upland game hunting, small game hunting, even medium game hunting to a degree, using different deer slugs and stuff like that, and buckshot can be done with a 20 gauge. And while it is, like I said, a little bit larger, it does a very good job at being versatile in hunting. So I like its capabilities. Its major con, though, for me, is the fact of its overall size and weight. It's not a very portable firearm to bring into the field, but if you're going to be out in the field for a couple days, a week, you know, where hunting is definitely going to be a reality, this is my top choice because for a hunting driven firearm, a shotgun is one of the best things to have, and it's very rugged, very reliable. Plus you get a pretty good capacity of 5 shots in the tubular magazine, and like I said, you can mix up that shot. So if you know you're going after squirrels and rabbits, you can, you know, tailor your gun to taking them down better. Or if you're going after things like grouse, ptarmigan, you know, or duck, whatever, you can tailor your shotgun with the according load for that animal. And lastly, but certainly not least, and this is probably maybe one of the more arguable choices, but for my multi-role is going to be an AR-15, and this one specifically in 300 blackout. So 300 blackout round, guys can see there, a little bit bigger than the 223, but what I honestly like about the AR platform, and the reason why I chose this as a multi role, or my top multi role, is that due to the round that it fires, the 300 blackout, it's not necessarily gonna be a small game round, but it certainly makes a really good medium game round. It also makes a good defense round, so not only can you take down things like black bears, but you can also take down things like deer with this rifle. So I know definitely in certain parts of Alaska, like Southeast, where there's a high population of deer and bear, ironically, this would be a really good option. This would actually be my top pick for that area because I could have this gun, which is reasonably easy to port into the field, because the nice thing is You know, you just pull a couple pins, not to mention the magazine capacity is also nice, and the versatility of the rifle. If I did need to, I could swap out the barrels. Obviously, in a bushcrafting setting, I wouldn't be carrying multiple, but if I knew I was going to be more strictly toward hunting or protecting, I could tailor this system to that. And I think for the overall versatility that this option, or that this option offers, it definitely is why I picked it. So like I said, the other reason why I picked it is not just the versatility of ammo. So the other reason I chose this system, if I can get this to come out. So the other reason I chose this system is because it's not only versatile in its rounds, but it's also portable. So for me, a multi-role has to be one portable and two versatile. So minus this sling, which is still holding it together, if I really wanted to, I could very easily put this in a backpack, just about any backpack. I may have to take this forward grip off, but really it would not be that hard to throw this long of a system into my backpack and have it broken down. And then when I'm going into the field, just simply, you know, take this, pop these pins, take this and just pop it back together, and then have my rifle serviceable for my bushcrafting operations. So that way I can easily pack it into the field, but then unpackage it and have the rifle ready to go. So that is why this makes my top multi-role or kind of utilitarian choice or pick, because like I said, I can push this into either role, whether I need this to be for hunting or whether I need it for defense. It also is very portable, so it's not going to be constantly weighing me down like the larger shotgun. So that's my top pick from the multi-role, and hopefully you guys have enjoyed taking a quick look at my top firearms for bushcraft. Like I said, it's a little bit of a hard choice, or hard to just pick one firearm because of the many different things we do as bushcrafters, but these are my top choices and what I've honestly used out in the field for bushcrafting, especially as far as handguns go, and what I've learned to like and what I've learned to not like. So anyways, hopefully you've enjoyed that. As always, guys, God bless, and I'm out.